Good morning, everyone. It's just great to see everybody here. Thanks for being here. And let's be in the state of meditation together with a lot of silence. So let's now together namaskar, put our Agni and humble down and stretch our arms out as much as we can towards the photo while we do that. And then raise our Kundalini and put ourselves in Bandham.
Shri Mahalakshmi Mahasaraswati Mahakali Trigunatmika Kundalini Sa Shri Adi Shakti Mata Ji Shri Nirmala Devi Namaha Om Tvame Shri Kalki Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mata Ji Shri Nirmala Shri Kalki Sakshat Shri Sahasrar Swamini Moksha Pradayini Ma Shri Nirmala Namo Namo Tvameva Sakshat Shri Ganesha Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devyai Namo Namaha.
We now have a few minutes just in silence to clear any catches. What I usually do in the morning, I just ask for the catches that need to be cleared. So it doesn't matter if it's my own, of our group meditating together, or the environment that you're in. Just ask in general. In the morning, we don't use our hands. Sri Manaji said, don't use our hands to give vibrations. So we just do the mantras, and then we go into a silence before the talk of Sri Manaji.
What is our job is to worship Mahakali within us. Because what does she do? Perhaps we are not very aware of. First and foremost thing she does is to protect us. Wherever you may be, whatever you may be doing, in whatever peril you may be, howsoever dangerously you may be placed in life, she protects. First thing, she protects you. All the people who write to me how they were protected, how they were cured, how they were helped, is this thing, that they should know that all this has happened because of Mahakali power within you. She exists within you. When you are worshipping Mahakali, you are worshipping the Mahakali within you. With due respect, you must know that this Mahakali is a very sensitive personality. She is very sensitive. If you try to do any wrong to anyone, she'll guide you. She'll tell you by many ways that this is wrong you are doing, why you are doing wrong to some person. But if you do not repent and come back onto the normal position, she gives you up. Once Mahakali gives you up, you are now exposed and become prone to all kinds of evil things. So when you worship her, what do you want? You want her to protect you. In your discrimination, in your mistake, you might do something wrong. May do something that is not good for you, could be very dangerous for you. But she's the person who guides you how to avoid all the dangers. Now she protects your life. She protects your body. She protects all organs of your body. She's the one who gives you all the security of life. In her realm, you feel completely secure. You are never afraid of anything. Because you have left her realm, you have come out of it. That's why, that is the reason you are afraid. But if you are under her beautiful guidance and her blessings, you will never feel afraid to do anything. You will never do anything wrong also. As soon as you will try to do wrong, she will hold your hand. She is really the guiding person. She is the one who actually gives us our existence. Without her, we cannot exist. Because she is the one who is the power of Sri Shiva. She gives us so many things. For example, she gives us the relaxation, the sleep. She gives you the truth. She tells you what is the truth and what is not. Sometimes people, so much in their ego, always try to believe that what I think is the truth. Then she's the one who points it out by creating a maya, a kind of a confusion that you start thinking, what is this? So she is called also the one who gives us bhranti, means illusions. She puts you to illusions also. She tests you, puts you to illusions, and she then ultimately takes you out of the illusions. She is the one who relaxes you because she takes over all your responsibilities. She takes over all your problems. She's the one who solves all the problems. It is we who forget to leave all the problems to her. If you just leave problems to her, all your problems are solved. Not only that, but you really feel blessed. It's not only physical, also it's mental, that she makes your mind absolutely free of worries. She doesn't worry. And she doesn't want you to worry. If you worry, then she tries to show that by your worrying, you are denying her. You are not accepting her. Worrying is something is very common and people take great pride in saying, oh, I was worried. How can you be worried when your mother is Sakshat Mahakali? She can kill all her demons, she can finish all of them. She knows how to manage things. And when you are like a child before her, how can you worry about it? So your worries are finished. She worries about you, you shouldn't worry about yourself. That's the point. Her security is so great. She's so secured herself that she gives you all the security that you need. You can hold on to her feet, you can hold on to her image or to anything. You can even pray to her. Many people are being cured only by praying to her because she cures you. She can cure your diseases, which are very complicated diseases, she can cure. Now what she likes, Mahakali, likes the light. She's worshipped in the night because then we can put on the lights. She likes enlightened person. Also, she likes the light. She likes the sun. She likes something that will be completely enlightened and brightened. You must have heard about people who are called, I don't know what, but especially in the West, they use them. They have big teeth. And they and they are the people, they just imagine, they cannot exist before the sun. As soon as there is a sunrise, they just want to go off and sleep. Whereas they cannot see the sun because the light they can't bear. Now what has happened here, that Mahalakshmi has departed. Mahakali has departed from them. And when Mahakali has departed, then they are afraid. And such people are attacked by these people who know they are afraid. The sun itself is very important to work out this Mahakali thing. But as it is in the West especially, we are very hard-working and very much sun-oriented, and we worship the sun. All this we do, worship the sun and also go right-sided very much. Then it is she who gives us the balance. She's the one who gives us the balance by relaxing us completely and protecting us. Sometimes we are competitive and we are really worried and we want to do something which we cannot do, then we get upset and we don't know what to do. Then it is she who brings sleep to us. So when we sleep, she looks after us, she soothes us, and she takes away our problems. So many things she's doing. But what are we doing for her, that we should see. Main thing is that we are ourselves worshipping her. She likes that her children should worship her. That on that level she can be one with them. She can give them her compassion, love and protection from all the evil. But it has to be understood, those who are not yet settled, those who are not yet absolutely belonging to that land of security of Mahakali, can be attacked. And they, once they leave that area, they can be very badly injured, killed, whatever may can happen. So we are living in this Kali Yuga in a very dangerous times, when anything can happen. So we have to be very careful. We have to watch our mind to see how it works. What does it teach you? What does it tell you? Try to understand. What is the plan of this evil person that you are praying into his hands? How can you pray into his hands? And how can you do whatever wrong he wants you to do? Secondly, against her is the ego. The biggest problem is the ego today. Ego shows, no, I can do this. Ego says, I will work it out. Ego says, it will be done. But the human beings yield to ego. It's a great satisfaction for them that their ego is so strong and they don't want to listen to the Mahakali forces. You have to be like children. Really, that's the very best way, is to be innocent like children. She loves innocent people. She's innocent herself. She loves innocent people. And she looks after you much more because you're innocent. You're not cunning. You're not very much trying to play your ego on others. If you're innocent, she'll help you. She definitely will help you. But this ego has to be brought under control. Because he is the worst enemy she has. She doesn't like your ego. She wants you to be egoless, to be innocent. Then another thing she loves in you is your compassion. Compassion for each other. Love for each other. Also caring for others. That is something she loves. If you are a Sahajogi, if you are a realized soul, she's always with you. But she says, what are you doing with your compassion? How many people you are giving realization? How many people you are curing? How many people you are helping? She is quite aware of whatever you are doing. I should say, it's such a tremendous power of Mahakali that she knows everything about you. Everything. She knows your mind. She knows your heart. She knows about your health. Everything she knows, actually, she is the mother in every way who cares for the little child. In that way, she knows that this child doesn't know anything. He's very innocent. So like when you are very small, your mother looks after you. In the same way, this Mahakali looks after you. Everywhere in your life, she is there. Especially with Sahajogis. She follows them up and down. Everywhere, whatever you are doing, you are in an accident, she's there to save you. She's like an angel behind you. And nothing can happen to you if you really worship her from your full heart. Not for any gain, not for any achievement, but for her blessings. Her blessings are very great and they really have enriched human beings. They have enriched this earth. They have enriched everything because of the blessings of Mahakali. It will be the best way is to meditate. Not to be aggressive in any way, but just to meditate and ask Mahakali, destroy. Destroy him. For he's destroying the world. You please destroy. That's her job. And she would love to do. But somebody has to tell her and ask her. It's very good because there are so many that unless and until you point it out, she may not be able to put her attention to them, possibly. So it's best is always ask her to help you on individual basis, on a national basis, maybe on a collective basis, or maybe on a global basis. That's what she exists everywhere. She is globally available. Anywhere you may be having any color, any race, any nation, anything. But she exists within you all the time. And to worship her and to awaken her is only your due that you have to do. You have to do it in a way that is an innocent act, that you are worshipping your mother like a little child worships and loves his mother. It's a very simple relationship which all of us have failed. How we should love our mother and how we should be under her guidance and under her protection. That is something very simple you have known in your childhood, and that childhood has to come back in you if you really worship the mother. May God bless you.
Please stay for a little while for the Om meditation. If you prefer to continue to meditate in silence, you can just turn the volume off and still stay in the collective vibrations here. I wish you now a wonderful day today, and I'll see you next time.